So here we will discuss Bowley's coefficient of skewness. It is defined as Sk is equal to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2Q2 whole divided by Q3 minus Q1. So basically this coefficient of skewness is based upon our quartiles value, where you can say Q1, Q2 and Q3 are first, second and third quartiles value. So here if your skewness value is less than 0, then this implies Q3 plus Q1 is less than 2 times of Q2, or you can say in this case your distribution is negatively skewed. Now the second case, when if your skewness value is 0, then in this case Q3 plus Q1 is equal to 2 times of Q2, and you can say in this case your distribution is symmetrical. That is, in this case your median value is equidistant from first and third quartile. Now if your skewness value is greater than 0, then you can say in this case Q3 plus Q1 is greater than 2 times Q2 value, and distribution is in this case positively skewed. Now limits of Bowley's coefficient of skewness is, its minimum value is minus 1 and its maximum value is 1. So value of Bowley's coefficient of skewness will lie between minus 1 and 1. Now you can write in a note that situations when we prefer Bowley's coefficient of skewness over Carl Pearson's, actually our Carl Pearson's coefficients based upon mean median mode. So when mode is ill-defined, then we can use Bowley's coefficient. You can write the first situation is when mode is ill-defined. Now the second case, when extreme observations are present. When extreme observations are present, then we can't calculate the mean value, so we can use Bowley's because it depends on quartiles value. Now the third case is when distribution has open end class. In this situation we also can't find out arithmetic mean, so we can use Bowley's coefficient of skewness. And the last one is when distribution has unequal class interval. In these four cases we can use Bowley's coefficient of skewness over Carl Pearson's. Now we will discuss coefficient of skewness based upon moments.